decent harvest. I'm not so sure about the vegetables, though.
Well, my carrots and radishes are coming along nicely, but something's taken advantage of some of my apple trees.
You know the head they found near the scaffolding?
What about it?
Someone put it there on purpose, after they stuck horns on it to make it look sinister.
What a ridiculous thing to do. Who's responsible? And where did he find the skull?
I don't know, but I'll try to find out. Have you seen Leszek, the scaffolder?
I saw him. What do you want with him?
I want to talk to him about the head he dug up.
Really? That's interesting.
Why?
He asked me to meet him on the scaffolding tonight, so he can tell me something important. Said he wanted to confess something.
So he did have something to do with the skull. I knew it.
Maybe. But I'd wager someone made him do it. He doesn't seem the type to come up with something like that on his own. I'm planning to go and meet him. Will you come with me?
It will be safer with the two of us. I'll go.
Very well. We'll meet at night. If I'm not down at the bottom, then look for me at the top.
All right.
I hope I can be of some humble service to you.
I looked around, and the stone that fell on that man is different from the rest.
Yes, it's very poor, but we have to work with what we've got. We didn't have anything else, and we couldn't wait for more.
That's not what I meant. It's not the same kind of stone that came from Talmberg. Someone must have switched it.
But why would anyone do that?
Well, maybe he was stealing new stone and replacing it with old stuff. Or to sabotage the construction, I don't know.
But the carriage never moved. It rained a lot and we couldn't get any work done, or we'd have been up to our ankles in mud.
So someone had to take it out without being seen?
That huge piece of rock. It would take a few strong men to shift something that size. I know you're trying to help, but someone would have noticed. It couldn't be done without anyone seeing it.
The skull is a fake. Someone fixed horns on a human skull.
But where would they get a human skull? And why would they do it?
Maybe to frighten the workers? Raise the price?
But that wouldn't help anyone. It had to be some idiot's idea of a prank. An idiot who was nearly responsible for getting a man killed.
God be with you. Don't kill me. I'll tell you everything. Who are you? I'm just a worker here. He told me that if I take care of you, then he'll forgive my debts. I didn't want to, but he forced me to do it. Who sent you? It was the Master Builder's helper. Young Smola.
What? He was supposed to be here as well.
He isn't. He went to the mill nearby when he found out Leshak was hiding out there.
Fuck! What am I supposed to do with you? You tried to kill me.
I was aiming to miss. On purpose. I wanted to scare you off and then say I missed. Don't kill me, please!
Fine, but I don't want to see you here again.
Thank you.
Yeah. What the hell are you doing? That's Leszek, isn't it?
Yes, it's him. I found him. And now I'm taking him to the Sawbones.
I'd say he's dead as a doornail. You killed him, didn't you?
Not at all. Look, he's still breathing.
On again. Go ahead and gather your strength. You'll need it. Ow. You're dead. Bring it on. Take that. Dear God. Thank you.
The Lord watch over you, Henry.
Hey.
I've got good news, sir. The source of the problem was inside the monastery. There was nothing more to it.
And the construction?
We'll continue. The master builder's helper was to blame for everything. With him out of the way, the work will run smoothly again.
That's good. You've accomplished your task admirably, Henry. And I should reward you for it.
Thank you, Sir Divish.
Farewell.